Hello guys, Danny here from Dan's Tech. In this video I'm going to be bringing you a high-end CPU cooler comparison video comparing many high-end CPU coolers on the market today. That's going to include the Noctua NHD15, the GamerStorm Assassin 2, Cryorig Aeon Universal, Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 3, and also the Riven Okinos. All these are, just checking, yes, they're all dual tower coolers and do come with two fans. Although these do vary, all these coolers are very high performing, and some of them being incredibly quiet, including this one here, the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 3. This one is one of the ones that might stand out in terms of the noise levels, with it being very quiet. It might not be one of the highest performing from all of these, but yeah, regardless, I'm going to bring you guys the comparison. It's going to be quite a long video, but hopefully by the end of it, you'll know which one's the best in terms of density, performance, noise levels, ease of installation. There's going to be many awards I'm going to be giving many of these CPU colours. I had a fifth award on my mind, but I've lost it. Oh well. But yeah, without further ado, guys, let's jump into the video. And yeah, let's compare all these high-end CPU coolers. So maybe to get started, we're going to be having a quick look at each cooler, going over some specs before getting into some tests on the performance of these coolers. Of course, with an aim to not make this video half an hour and to be relatively short. First up, we have the popular NHD15 from Noctua, coming in at 165mm in height, 161mm in depth, and 150mm in width. And with a total weight being 1.32 kilograms, this cooler is rather large. Now, like all the coolers in this comparison, they are all dual tower coolers. This one features 6 copper heat pipes and 2 140mm fans. The overall colouring for this unit is silver and brown, and as for the main accessories in the box, these include thermal compound, low noise adapters, a wire splitter cable, as well as a custom screwdriver. Moving on to the GamerStorm Assassin 2 from Deepcool, it comes in at 167mm in height, 158mm in depth, and 143mm in width, with the total weight being 1.27 kg. Again, this is a dual tower cooler, with this one featuring 8 heat pipes and a 120 and 140mm fan. The overall colouring for this unit is red, black, and silver, and as for the main accessories in the box, these include thermal compound, a 4 fan hub, allowing you to connect also to 2 case fans. Next up, we have the Dark Rock Pro 3 from Be Quiet, coming in at 163mm in height, 150mm in depth, and 137mm in width. It's one of the smaller units. The total weight is 1.19 kg. Now, this cooler in itself is quite different to all the others here today, however, it's still a high performance dual tower cooler, featuring 7 heat pipes and a 120 and 135mm fan. For cooling, this cooler aims to be a quieter unit. Now, the main colouring for this unit is fully black. And as for the accessories, you'll find a sachet of thermal compound and a splitter cable integrated into the smaller 120mm fan. Next up, we have a unit from Riven, meet the Okinos. This cooler comes in at 163mm in height also, 142mm in depth, and 135mm in width. The total weight of this cooler is 1.1 kg. This cooler features 2 slim towers and 6 heat pipes, of which 2 are very large, are 8mm thick, with the others at 6mm. The fans are 120mm and 140mm and are coloured yellow, making this cooler overall yellow, black and silver. Main accessories in the box for this cooler include thermal compound and 2 low noise adapters. And finally, we have the cooler I reviewed in the most recent video, the Cryorig Aeon Universal. This unit comes in at 168mm in height, the tallest unit, 142mm in depth, and 129mm in width. The total weight of this cooler is 1.21 kg. The cooler features 2 towers with a total of 7 heat pipes. Both of the fans that ship with this cooler are 140mm, one being a slimline fan at 13mm thick. These are black and go well with the white, black and silver colour of the cooler overall. Main accessories in the box include thermal compound, a alcohol wipe and a custom black screwdriver. Moving on to the performance, the test system is running an Intel Core i7-4790K clocked at both 4.0 and 4.4 GHz with the auto voltage simply set to serve as a factor to increase heat generation. Now this graph shows overall performance, showing the top dogs at the top and the coolers that didn't perform as well at the bottom. The Riven Okinos and the Noctua NHD15 both earned top spots with their fantastic performance. Also displayed are the temperatures from the coolers that shift with low noise adapters. Some coolers do trade positions, going from 4.4 to 4 GHz, but most coolers do stay in line. As for the acoustics, it's best for me to hand you over to the sound clips of each colour and let my Zoom H4n microphone do the talking. These are the sound tests at 4.4 GHz, showing the Okinos and the NHD15 are the quietest coolers with their LNAAs attached. Onto the price of each unit in line with its performance, this next graph shows the price to performance of each cooler, both in US dollars and Great British pounds. To work out which gives the most value, we can simply divide the cost by the temperature reached at 4.4 GHz. The lower the value, the better. This shows the NHD15 is the best cooler in terms of value for money in both the USA and here in the UK. Unfortunately, the Revan Okinos is unavailable to purchase in the UK, so that was left out of the equation. As for mounting all these coolers, you can check out all the individual reviews I've produced, or on my second channel on YouTube dedicated to mounting coolers. This will be linked in the video description. Some take more time to install and some are simpler to mount on different platforms. I'll let you decide which ones are trickier to install by checking out all the videos on the other channel. However, I will say the Noctua NHD15 and Darkrock Pro 3 from Be Quiet are among the easiest to install from the lot. And lastly, onto another interesting metric, how well the coolers perform in line to their overall volume. We can work out this by dividing the total volume by the performance at 4.4 GHz. For this particular test, the higher the value, the better, showing the NHD15 is the best cooler in terms of volume to performance, with the R1 Universal not being so good in this department with its larger size and mediocre performance. So guys, that concludes my comparison of all these high-end CPU coolers. If I've got to pick one or two favourites, it's probably going to be the Noctua NHD15. It's just so easy to install, and regardless of the brown poo-poo fans, I just really do like Noctua's products in general. And the second one is going to be the Assassin 2. The Assassin 2 does feature red fans, so I feel it's going to suit a lot of people's rigs. Many, many graphic cards and motherboards are red, so yeah. But you can see why it's going to match a load of rigs. Now, if you want to check out any of the individual reviews of any of these coolers, do feel free to check in the description, or at the end of the video, we'll have them kind of all linked all over the screen, so you can click on them and watch individual reviews. And yes, that's going to kind of be the end of the video. Hopefully you've enjoyed, and if you were, say, comparing two or three of these, you now know which one to pick. If you have any comments, do post them in the good old description. And yeah, if you are thinking of buying any of these, do have a look in the good old description box. You'll find all Amazon links of these products, as well as links to the manufacturer's websites with further specs and photographs. So guys, thank you very much for watching. Please feel free to like, comment, and also subscribe. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Goodbye. Would you believe it? I actually get ragged for reviewing so many high-end CPU coolers. I think you're just all jealous, lads.